name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our prayer, and the communion of the Holy Spirit
be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In today's Gospel, before choosing 12 apostles, Jesus went up the mountain to pray. And today morning, we have been praying to God when we are at the sacrament on the altar. When we are praying for something, and someone do not give up, your prayers are not answered. You all believe in the miracles. Because only believe in the miracles, and God is going to make a way for all of us to come back to Him. As God, this morning, let us recall the sins that we have been in and ask the Father to give us. I confess.
Reading from the letter to the Hebrews, brothers and sisters. Now our high priest has obtained so much more excellent a ministry, as he is mediator of a better covenant, enacted on better promises. For if that first covenant had been faultless, no place would have been sought for a second one. But he finds fault with them and says, "Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will conclude a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them by the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt. For they did not stand by my covenant, and I ignored them, says the Lord. But this is the covenant I will establish with the house of Israel. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my laws in their minds, and I will write them upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. And they shall not teach each one his fellow citizen and kin, saying, Know the Lord, for all shall know me, from least to greatest. For I will forgive their evil doing, and remember their sins no more. When he speaks of a new covenant, he declares the first one obsolete, and is grown old, is close to disappearing. The word of the Lord. Kindness and truth shall meet.
Kindness and truth shall meet.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land.
Kindness and truth shall meet.
Kindness and truth shall meet. Justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven.
Kindness and truth shall meet.
The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his steps.
Kindness and truth shall be.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, entrusted to us the message of reconciliation.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went up to mountain and summoned those whom he wanted, and they came to him. He appointed 12, whom he also named apostles, that they might be with him, and he might send them forth to preach, and to have authority to drive out demons. He appointed the 12. Simon, whom he named Peter, James, son of Zebedee, and John, the brother of James, whom he named Bornegius, that is, son of Thunder, Andrew, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon of Cananea, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
We have been praying yesterday and today forever. We are going to pray for the right to life. Life is a gift from God. God is giving life as a gift, and you and I have no right to take it out. But because of the bad situations, because of the bad decisions, because of the culture, because of so many various reasons, so many of us still not respecting the right to life. The simple solution is give it up, destroy it, get rid of it. But the more we are doing those kind of things, they are going to come back to us all the time. I really appreciate most of all the parishioners, and also so many people around the globe still fighting for the life, still praying for the unborn babies. But whenever I go to the cemeteries, I always pass by the little ones. Here I did not see a separate section for the little babies, but in mainland, there is a small section for them. Whoever was aborted, they bring the babies and they bury there. There's a beautiful prayer saying that, Lord, these are smallest innocents. They never committed sin. How they made a bad decisions to end the life. Forgive all those mothers. Forgive all those people, those who made a bad choice. And give them a second chance. They will prove it. We all deserve a second chance from God. When God gives a second chance, we should not misuse of it. We have to try our best to prove that we are also so precious. But in India, I do not know now, we don't hear much, but in India, even in the villages, if they know that they're going to have a baby girl, they try to kill her in the womb or when they give birth. Why? Because the poor people cannot afford to give dowry. Dowry means we have to give lots of money during their wedding. But until today, those things are taking place. But thanks be to God, so much awareness is there. And people are talking about how precious it is, the life. And today, we are going to participate virtually in the rally 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Please take part in it. And please pray for someone who made those bad decisions and choices, that the Lord may embrace them and welcome them. And today's gospel is amazing. Every day we receive a call from God to do something in our lives. Before choosing the 12, Jesus did not go somewhere else and calling them by phone, maybe sending email, maybe Facebook or something. Nothing. He went up to the mountain. Before he went up the mountain, he called them one by name with their working. They generously answered the call of God. After living with him a couple of days, maybe a couple of months, he went up to the mountain and talking to his father. Father, today I'm going to take this decision to call the apostles so that they can go out and proclaim the kingdom of God. He called each and every one of them. He knew about their lives. Even so many people complained, calling Matthew as a public sinner. How come he's going to serve you? How come he's going to be a apostle? And Peter is going to deny you three times. How he's going to be the Petros, the rock on which you are going to build the church. And Judas Iscariot, I'm sure, is going to betray you because of him, and you are going to die on the cross. Maybe God has a plan for Jesus Christ like that. That's why, even though he knew their flaws and sins and brokenness, but still, he called them, hoping that they're going to change, become a faithful servant to proclaim the kingdom of God. Not only that, when he appointed, when he sent them, he gave them power and authority. Power and authority, not for the church, not to do anything, but to preach the kingdom of God, to drive out the demons and the evil spirits. And one day they knew that. Because of this truth, they are going to give up their lives. Like that, except John, everybody faced martyrdom or merciless killing. But today, Jesus is calling all of us to do something.
Amen.
Even though we know that something is going to happen, but still, we should trust in our Lord Jesus Christ. Say, yes, Lord, here I am to do your will. But today, as I said, pray for the vocations too. There are so many young people. We always believe that many are called, few are chosen. But there are so many out there waiting for you, waiting for me to talk to them how God is going to call them, how they can become the instruments to proclaim the kingdom of God. If God can call all these 12 sinners, if God called all these people, among them they were sinners, the saints, but they became saints. I always believe that we are sinners, but a saint is living within ourselves. But today is the day to bring out the saint and ask him or her to do the will of God. Amen.
Amen.
As we pray for the legal protection of the unborn in our nation, let us bring our prayers and petitions before God. He may hear us and answer us.
For vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, for a generous response to the Lord's call, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who govern, may the Lord grant them wisdom and a moral heart in their work to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who live in situations where they are oppressed, intimidated, or scared, may God's grace and courage fill their hearts and give them strength. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all gathered here, may we, through the Lord's grace and providence, grow in the virtues of faith. Let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, family and friends who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith, may they enter into the fullness of life in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. For our personal intentions, for the special intentions of this Mass, which are for those afflicted with the coronavirus and for the protection of all families, for the protection of the healthcare frontliners and all involved in preventing the spread of the virus. we pray to the Lord.
Glory to God, praise.
For the eternal repose of the soul of Teddy Royal Sr. We pray to the Lord.
Glory to God, praise.
Together let us pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Heavenly Father, you created us in your image and likeness, even more and more wonderfully and beautifully. Redeem us with your Son, our Lord Jesus. Hear the prayers now as we offer. May answer according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The Savior's commandment of following the divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, in your apostles, peace and evil, peace and evil. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity, according to their will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us help each other with the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold the Redeemer of the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into your house, but only say,
Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love and your kindness. Make those who have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and one in heart. We ask this for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Be with you. Bless you and your families, the Father and the Son.
Thank you.
weighing, I think I gained 50 pounds. But I am going to, I am...
I've been trying to do yard work, so I'm almost at the house.
I know. And me, ever since I got a car, which was last May, and I've been without a car for 13 years, right? So I kept saying to myself, how come I've been without a car and I'm still overweight? Well, after I started having a car, because I would take the bus and walk places, right? So after I started having a car, then I really started gaining the weight. That and the stupid COVID thing, all of it together made it like, oh my gosh. So now I gotta go and really make myself do some exercise.